Societe Generale takes a step even further down the DeFi rabbit hole. This one is pretty crazy to me. This is SocGen working with MakerDAO. This is a decentralized lending platform, one of the OGs of the DeFi space. And a bank is doing this right now with MakerDAO, which is crazy to me. You would not have seen this a year ago, 2 years ago. This is this to me is quite interesting. I'm going to kick this straight to Will since it's DeFi day. Will, SocGen, MakerDAO, kind of a striking collabo. I don't know. What are your thoughts?
It's weird for me because I've heard of MakerDAO. I haven't heard of SocGen before. And apparently that's a really big deal. But I think that's a lot of people in the crypto world. We know about the crypto products. We don't know about these huge banks. And now these huge banks are coming to these crypto projects and they're saying, hey, can we kind of figure out how to work together on some sort of experiment and see if there's something here for consumers. And there is something here for consumers in my mind's eye. MakerDAO is a really interesting project. It's one of the oldest, if not the oldest DeFi project out there. You're able to take out loans in a peer-to-peer fashion through this DAO that just is uncensorable. Very cool project. I don't have a lot of takes on Societe Generale getting involved here because I have seen MakerDAO get involved with some stuff like this in the past. I think this one's just kind of getting brought up to the top of the pot, so to speak, because it's such a large bank. But we have seen MakerDAO onboard real-world collateral before. They've had some, Ian Allison has done some great reporting at CoinDesk previously on something like railroad bonds being put onto MakerDAO. We've also seen MakerDAO be sued in court before, which brings into some questions about, is MakerDAO like totally a DAO? Is it totally decentralized? And if you look into the weeds of this document with SocGen, you see that they are talking about appointing a legal representative for MakerDAO so they can interact with this contract and kind of look at the ways that, you know, you have to bring this DAO into the meat space in some sense of the word, which is really tough. So I think from an experimental point of view, it's really interesting. It's a continuation of things that MakerDAO has been doing for years. I think this headline is just kind of popping up right now because we are in the midst of a bull run. Jen, did your hand go up? I can never see whose hand went up. I get so focused on what I'm saying.
I know, I'm just so like laser focused on DeFi Fridays. So I just have a question. This is a really cool but seemingly complex project. And one of the goals that was outlined in the article was to prove out the legal framework. And while I was reading this, I kind of thought about like, what would happen if this partnership were to happen in the States? And I immediately just saw all of these like red alarm bells when it came to the SEC and how this works. Is this something, Zach, that could happen in the States or has regulation kind of pushed that option away?
I don't know. I wouldn't hold my breath to see like a US entity try to do this. But hey, you know, I think there are people who believe that there are some regulatory guardrails for stuff like this. I don't think a lot of people share that view, so I wouldn't expect to see a U.S. Regulated entity take a step such as this. But it is interesting that this is happening the way it's happening. It's a complex arrangement. It's interesting to see. You know, you have the Maker Foundation, which is in the process, I think, of dissolving itself and just doing full DAO, full Maker DAO. Maker Foundation has been the longtime steward of this project up until fairly recently. Forget when they announced that they were spinning down the foundation itself and just going to the DAO structure. But it's going to be interesting to see which entities carry out this stuff and whether or not you know, big name financial brands such as Societe Generale can participate in some of these decentralized lending markets going forward. Whether that's in Europe or in the US, probably likely to see it in Europe and elsewhere for the time being. I saw Will's hand go up, so I'm going to toss it to him.
Yeah, you missed a fact check on me, so I'll do it to myself. MakerDAO itself was not sued in open court. What there's been in the past has been some movements by people who have been involved in MakerDAO to get reclaimed funds from the Maker Foundation. And so they tried to take the Maker Foundation to court. I'm not sure where that litigation ended up. But the point being that when you have these two, like you have physical entities like Societe Generale trying to work with a project that is totally on-chain, things can get really messy and confusing, especially when you get into the legal system. So Jen, I think that kind of ties back to your point there. Like, would something like Societe Generale, MakerDAO make sense in the US? Well, it's kind of hard to say because the regulations around lending can be quite confusing, especially when you add an on-chain aspect to this whole deal. Naomi?
Yeah, I think this is really cool. It makes a lot of sense to me that institutions are starting to get into the space as well. Individuals have found the benefits of loans for a long time, but now banks are saying, okay, maybe we can put up debt as collateral. I mean, MakerDAO is interesting in that the community is going to have to vote on whether they accept this. You can't just put anything as collateral, obviously. And so they have to actually, you know, vote on whether or not to integrate this. We chatted yesterday on the show about how it's really difficult to get voter turnout, to incentivize people to actually have a say in this. And I wonder whether something like, because I love MakerDAO, I love DAI, you know, I love that whole system. I think it's a really cool and been a fascinating project to watch evolve. But I do hope that it doesn't devolve into taking on crazy risky assets like, giant fractional reserve banks that, we're trusting them and trusting that their collateral is actually good. Like, I just feel like when groups come together and vote on things, they don't necessarily make the best decisions and assess risk particularly rigorously. Furthermore, not everyone turns out to vote, which is a good thing, but you can't guarantee that the people who are actually, making good decisions are the ones turning out. So it's just, I mean, it definitely is something to keep an eye on in systems like this, because it is completely decentralized. You don't really have a visionary leading it and someone making good decisions and making sure, there's accountability as well. When you don't have a single person making decisions, there's no one to put the blame on if something goes wrong. So people probably less rigorous with their decisions. So I hope that this isn't one of those situations. I would be hesitant to get involved with debt issued this from a bank.
This is like the week that Naomi got like red-pilled into centralized control. This is striking. I feel like we heard a note of this just the other day. Interesting. All right. Well,
yeah. No, it's not red pill. I love this. I love this, but I do think that we are very early in the process, and people are still realizing and figuring out what the risks associated with that.